We've been fortunate to have a couple of sponsors of this event with us today, not to mention, of course, the great support from the state and all of your team to do this event, but also Northwestern Energy, our investor-owned utility here, and Advantage South Dakota, which is the regional development mechanism that Northwestern Energy has extended to its member communities, are proud sponsors of this event. In addition, we have a lot of co-hosts. And I'll look to, there we go, came up. A lot of co-hosts that made this happen. The Aberdeen Area Chamber, the Aberdeen Area Convention and Visitors Bureau, the Aberdeen Development Corporation, the Aberdeen Downtown Association, that's our economic development infrastructure here. Beetle and Spink Enterprise Community is involved in our regional work. Fulton Economic Development Corporation, Grow Spink, Grow South Dakota, the Ipswich Community Economic Development, Northeast Council of Governments, Northeast South Dakota, AHEC, Northern State University Presentation College, the Small Business Development Center, and the Webster Area Community Development Corporation are all proud co-hosts of this event, and we work with these folks and several others in our region almost on a daily or weekly basis to seek their input on how we can get better at this together since we're all growing. So I want to thank you, thank all of them, and just so that you know some of the other faces that have been involved in this and some of the brain power around all of this. Aberdeen is growing, it's still growing. We're growing our population, we're growing jobs. Not only is Aberdeen growing, but the communities around us are growing. And we enjoy that together. We think regionally, we act regionally here. One of the reasons that Aberdeen is growing is that its leadership and followership decided to grow about 10 or 12 years ago, if you were to write the economic history of Aberdeen, which I'll have to do one of these days. And one of the reasons that is true is that we've had great local leadership. One of the common denominators during this time of growth is our mayor, the Honorable Mike Levsen. Please welcome him to the podium.
You know, there's an old saying in New York City politics, you know, if you ever see a parade, it doesn't matter what it is, just jump in front of it. And I've had the opportunity here to jump in front of this parade. And all of the great leadership, as Julia said, in both the business and the non-government organizations and the people not only in this community but in this region. And we always stress the story, and many of you here are not from the city of Aberdeen, that Aberdeen does not stop at the Aberdeen city limits, that all of our area is Aberdeen, and all of what they are is the reason for us being here. With that said, we're all part of the state of South Dakota as well, and we certainly welcome the governor being here. I'm glad you're here. I was wondering if you know you'd make it, maybe up late celebrating, partying, and you hung over today after your big victory last night.
Yeah, that's all true.
80%. So, I've run for mayor twice, and if you combine the percentages from both of those, it doesn't come up to 80. So. First time I think I ran against six or eight people and overwhelmed people with 30%. And then the second time with four people, I got 43. And then this time, the job is so unattractive that apparently nobody else wanted it. So I had a very easy day and was unopposed yesterday. So you're stuck with me for five more years, or thank you. Ran into Tom Hurlburt the other day, whose grandfather was the longest serving mayor of Aberdeen. I think it was 13 years, and he said, you know, you might pass that. And he said, might if you live that long. So we'll see. Also want to welcome Dusty here. The governor has designated Dusty to be somewhat of a liaison between the Class A mayors and his office. We have a group that meets, and Pierre, Mary Laurie Gill, and I co-chair that. We've kind of outlasted everybody else, so we're the head of that. She was also unopposed yesterday. And Dusty has been a huge help to us in a number of ways, in public and behind the scenes, in ways where we've needed help on things, and he and the governor have been a great asset to us as municipalities. So with that, I'm going to get out of the way, and we came here to hear the governor. I do want to say one more thing, and thanks to the governor before I end here. It was just announced within the last 10 days a $425,000 grant that the governor's office oversees from the Community Development Block Grants, and that will go toward our new Boys and Girls Club here in Aberdeen. So Governor, thank you, and Dusty and your office for that. So with that, this is an important day, and this is a very important subject for us. With all of the great things that have happened here in Aberdeen, and we don't just say them, we tell people, look at the numbers. You can measure it by almost all of the statistical measurements you look at for Aberdeen compared to the rest of the state, the rest of the country. With all of the great things that have happened here, we still have the ongoing frustration that we know what's here. We know what a wonderful place this is to live. We know how easy it is for someone, particularly in an entry-level position, to quickly move into a wonderful life in middle class and beyond. We know what we have to offer, and it's so frustrating that more people don't take advantage of that and come here to do it. And I hope as a result of this and all of our efforts, we can get more people to join us and enjoy the good life here in Aberdeen. And the governor's here to help us, so please welcome the Honorable Governor of the State of South Dakota, Dennis Dugard.